Those shows for me, it's on Netflix. lost me. I still watch it now and then, but as it went on, it became harder for me to like it, I guess. But it starts off this like young married couple. This guy is like head over heels for his new wife, and all of a sudden she like robs him blind and is gone, and then she's like a con artist basically, and he goes looking for her and finds all of these other people who she's done it to. I'm scrolling through all the cartoons on my account from my little 4-year-old, who also watches on my show, on my account. A Netflix original that I watched and I liked it, but it got, you know how sometimes the first couple episodes are so good and then they kind of take a turn for weird? That is definitely how this one is. It's called Behind Our Eyes. It starts off, there is this doctor. He and his wife have moved to this new town, and he has an affair with his secretary. But his wife knows all of this information that, like, you would only know if you were there. And then it kind of shows you how she knows, and it's interesting. There's, like, some astral travel going on and stuff, so I liked it, but I did not like how the first season ended. Okay, we are going to move over to Hulu now. Think that I watch a ton on Netflix. I have Hulu and I have HBO Max on Hulu, so I watch a lot more on Hulu than I do on Netflix. So I spent a lot of December, you know, like December is so cold here and it's dark so early, and I find myself watching a lot more TV in like November, December, January. So I actually sometimes will rewatch like my favorite series. So around Christmas time, I rewatched all of the Sex and the City episodes. That is one of my all-time favorite shows that I will never ever get sick of watching. And I also rewatched all of the episodes of Friday Night Lights. I love that show so much. So when I was pregnant with my fourth baby, I was on bed rest, and my kids are all born quite premature. So me and my sister kept talking about how like this baby was gonna be big. He's the last one. He's gonna be the biggest one. Like, positive thinking, right? So I was watching Friday Night Lights, and if you watch that show, then you know who I'm talking about. But I am like obsessed with Tim Riggins in that show. And so I kept saying that my baby was gonna be like Tim Riggins, like this big old linebacker baby. And I seriously even thought about naming him Riggins, which is kind of a weird first name, but I live in Utah and people have crazy names here. Like, they just make up names. So we always called him Baby Riggs when I was pregnant with him, and he was premature. He was tiny. He was 4 pounds when he was born, and I would just like hold him and call him Little Tim Riggins. And now he's 4, and he's a really big 4-year-old. So anyways, that was kind of a tangent, but I watched Friday Night Lights, and that's just always a good show in my opinion. My best friend texted me and she was like, "You have to watch Better Things on Netflix. It is so relatable." And so I've been binging that, and it's about this single mother and her three daughters. And it like parts of it are so relatable as just a mom. So I would recommend that show. It's kind of a filler show for me. It's really funny, but it's not something that like captivates my attention. I'm watching Grey's Anatomy. I have watched Grey's Anatomy since season one. I like own a lot of the seasons on DVD. This is probably my least favorite season ever, but I'm just so invested in watching this show for 17 years that I'm still watching it, even though, like, what they're doing with the pandemic and, like, Meredith, just, like, all the people they've killed off throughout the years coming back. Not my favorite season, but I will still watch it because I still, like, there are still characters I'm invested in. I'm also watching A Million Little Things. I like it. Like, it's a cute show about a group of friends. There's definitely some very dark undertones, but it's kind of a cute show. Another series that I watched, like, completely all over again is Entourage. And I loved that show so much when it came out, and I just rewatched it, and it has not aged well. I still love it. I think Ari Gold is one of my favorite characters ever. But the way they talk, like, they say a lot of very un-PC things. It's interesting, like, since I think the show came out in, like, 2000, early 2000s, and it's crazy how much we've shifted since then in the way we talk, you know? I am watching Big Sky, which I've talked about on here, or maybe it was, like, on a Patreon live, but it's right up your alley. I feel if you like this, like, my content here, it takes place in Montana, and it's, like, these two girls get kidnapped, and they're trying to find them, and it's pretty good, so. Everyone recommended Zoe's Extraordinary Playlist. Is that what it's called? Yeah. I didn't like it. I don't like musicals. I don't like when people are singing, like, it's so unrealistic, so I didn't like that. Also, everyone in Salt Lake is obsessed with The Real Housewives of Salt Lake City. And I love The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. That's the only one that I watch of The Real Housewives, but I was excited about the Salt Lake City one because it's, like, where I live, and I hated it. I didn't even finish the first season. I just thought it was boring, like, they were fighting. I don't know. It wasn't my favorite. I didn't give it a real chance. I think I got to, like, episode 5, and I was bored, so I did not watch that. Oh, another HBO show that it's kind of older, but I just recently watched it, was Big Love. And again, it takes place in Utah. It's like a polygamist family. And I actually really, really liked it. So that one's on HBO too. I think a lot of these are on HBO Max. One show that I have not watched yet, but it's brand new, and I am, like, I'm filming this on a Friday night, and then I'm excited to watch all weekend, is Cruel Summer. I heard that it is so good. Jessica Biel is the producer, and it says, like, on the little blurb about it, it says, from the executive producer, Jessica Biel, comes the chilling story of one girl, Katie Wallace, who goes missing, and another girl Messed up, but I was hoping because usually they come out around Christmas time. I've watched the last two seasons like during Christmas break, and now it's almost May, and I really want to see what happens in that show. That's a really good show. Again, if you like my channel, you'd probably like You. Dan from Gossip like the main character. I don't know his name in real life, but he becomes obsessed with women and then they disappear. So I really like that. I am very excited for the next episode of that. Okay, and let's go over to Prime Video. I don't know that I've watched anything on Prime for a long time, but see, I have a subscription to, I don't know what it's called, it's on Amazon Prime, I want to say it's like ID Discovery or something like that, where there's all these true crime documentaries and stuff, so I like to watch those when, I'm looking for a case that I haven't heard of. I like to take people's suggestions, but interesting. Most suggestions are like big cases that have been done like over and over. And so sometimes I just like to pull like a random case that I've never heard of off some cold case files or something like that and watch it and then research it and kind of go from there. Okay, so like I said, my Amazon is a lot of just true crime stuff. I recently watched Mean Girls, which is so random, but I have always really liked that show, so I decided to watch Mean Girls, which is interesting because I really almost never watch movies. Like, I don't know, are you guys like that where you would rather like get a show you're super invested in and watch like back to back to back? Or do you like movies? So I did watch Suits. I'm like way behind the game on that one. But I think I watched it in the fall. I haven't finished it because it kind of got to be like the same storyline over and over, kind of. But I really did like the first like four seasons were really good. We went to Montana for fall break. I have my TV on a lot, and then just just at night for like an hour or two. Sometimes I'll watch TV. So, yeah, that is what I've been watching. Let me know if you guys have suggestions. I'm always looking for suggestions. Right now I'm just watching some of my fillers that like I don't love. I need like a good show that like I'm excited to watch at the end of the day. You know what I mean? So anyway, I hope you guys are doing well. Give me your suggestions. Let me know what you think about any of the shows I covered. And I will see you guys on Monday for Mystery Monday.